Hello, dear people. Here are the Matrixers again, Shiva and Jonathan. And we are today. Well, who comes up with it? Who knows it? At Mount Shasta. We are on Mount Shasta and have now found a nice spot in the countryside. As you can see, there is a lot of fir forest here. It's very magical here. You can feel the energy of the mountain very clearly, and you can see it too, because the area here is much greener than all around, i.e. the next 100 kilometers around it. And here even moss grows on the trees. The ground is green. So you can already feel it. There's a little more going on here. Yes. We have already seen a few people sitting here somewhere in nature and meditating. So you can only drive your car up to a certain parking lot, and from then on the road is closed and you have to continue on foot. Our plan now is that we go into the inner earth. We're sitting here now and we're going to meditate for 10 minutes. That is of course completely sufficient. No joke. Yes, Mount Shasta is known for UFOs coming out of inner earth. You can often see that on photos, that there are huge clouds in the pictures above Mount Shasta, where a mother ship of the inner earth is supposed to be in there. Under Mount Shasta is not directly in the ground, there is the city of Telos. So at least that's a theory. We don't know if that's really true. But there's always those ring-shaped clouds that just come off Mount Shasta. And there it is claimed that this cloud serves as camouflage. Yes, that one does not get a shock that suddenly such a huge mothership or a huge spaceship is rising from Mount Shasta. Hard to imagine, but we are open to everything. Yes. And the inhabitants of Telos are said to be under Mount Shasta. And they announced it publicly, so to speak. If you want to go into the inner earth or going to Telos, should come to Mount Shasta and meditate there and wait for him to be addressed. Oh no, I didn't know anything. I find it good. Yes, and so we thought, we travel around so much anyway, that we could visit the inner earth. There's a lot to discover there, and there are quite a few continents. Yes, we have already made 3 videos about the inner earth. If you are interested in the inner earth, take a look at the videos. Now that's just a little update from us from Mount Shasta. Yes, be sure to check out our videos on the inner earth. Also very interesting. Also the interview with Sharula Dukes, who just claims that she is a princess of Telos. And then she talks about how they live down there, what kind of means of transport there is down there, how many people live there, historical connections. And of course she also tells us that she likes pizza. I can already feel the energy of the mountain very clearly. Everything vibrates here, my whole body. Yes, you can really feel the energy here. Yes. Mount Shasta is actually California's hotspot for spiritual people. Yes, exactly. So a lot of people come here and do workshops, dance, do rituals, meditate. Retreats are very popular here. So something is going on here. So if you are spiritually inclined, you are in good hands at Mount Shasta. There are several places to go here. You can drive to weed. Yes, it's spelled exactly as it's known, from weed. And excitingly, we now know that weed is legal in California. So you can theoretically buy weed in weed. That's fine. You can buy weed in weed. Yes, well, you can get pretty close to Mount Shasta from weed. But there are other ways, right? Well, there's only one road up Mount Shasta. Well, you have to drive into Mount Shasta place. You can do that either from Weed up north or from Reading down south. You then come to Mount Shasta and there a side road leads up to Mount Shasta. There aren't that many other ways to Mount Shasta. Yes. Okay. Yes, the town of Mount Shasta also exists, you said. This is a smaller town. And that's where weed comes in. Well, Mount Shasta is about 4,325, just for those who care. That's about half of Mount Everest. Yes, there are several hiking trails up here. Who cares? Yes, most of this is fir, greenery. So little deciduous you can find that below. We haven't seen any forest fires yet, fortunately. So Mount Shasta is still standing. And the forest around it too. Certainly Mount Shasta and the surrounding area is guarded by nature beings. Absolutely. So anyone who thinks he has to start a fire somewhere here will only have bad luck for the rest of his life. Then the nature beings follow you and give you the so-called Craig. And that means that from then on you're always kind of unlucky in life. So for those who would think of such nonsense at the moment. So some suspect that here on Mount Shasta, somewhere in a mountain, maybe even a so-called stargate, a stargate with which one can travel to other planets. One does not know whether that is true. But there is one or the other spiritual group that names itself after it and even gives workshops in the name of Stargate. That always means Stargate event or something like that. Yes, in any case, Mount Shasta is a place of power with its strong, enormous energies that you can absorb in order to free yourself from your old, stuck energies. Yes, you can let the energies of Mount Shasta flow through you. And since the energy is so high, naturally, the lower vibrating energy transforms into higher vibrating energy. And when you then let go of them, you also free yourself from the old and stuck. Yes, Shiva, what do we do now? I would say we meditate and ask for entry into the inner earth. Yes, very good. Let's pay them a visit down there. Let's see if they let us in. So we'll go into meditation and we thank you for watching. And until the next video or until the next live stream on Sunday, 2000. Take care. Bye.